Hello, welcome back to my project. This is Eric. It looks like the product in my hand is like a Raspberry Pi with a mini LCD. You can see the housing case as well as the USB ports next to it. But this is a product called the LilyPi based on ESP32. The graphics driver IC is ST7796 and it has a resolution of 3.5 inches for 80x320. It also includes a capacitive touch panel. Anyway, I will leave this one again in detail during the actual project. Today, I will briefly compare the ILI9480 in the previous video and the ST7796 of this product. There are some great demos supported by LVGL. This allows us to see the code as well as the available UI widgets. This is a great help to get your project started. In particular, drawing a UI where the code can be tricky. Of course, there is a UI editor, but this can't serve it 100%. The parts that need to be handled dynamically need to be drawn with the code sometimes. So it's recommended to review the demo or example sources provided officially by LVGL. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to run the LVGL demo. Let's get started. The part to test first is the graphic drivers. As in the previous video, I prepared TFT ESPi and LovyanGFX. What will the results be? I'm curious. Again, LovyanGFX is showing a bit of a read in all fields, but unlike before, the difference is very small. For reference, it's connected through a full wire SPI interface and is set to 40 MHz in the same way. In ILI9488, the speed of the screen output differs greatly depending on the graphics driver, but in ST7796, it can be seen that the speed of screen output does not differ significantly regardless of which driver is used. Since LovyanGFX shows better performance, I will use it as a graphic driver this time too. If there is a good chance, I will compare the speed of 8-bit pattern of ILI9488 and ST7796. From now on, I modify the code part of LovyanGFX so that ST7796 works based on the LVGL source codes created in the last video. First, change ILI9480 to ST7796. I'm gonna handle touch in different ways, so I will remove the touch part of LovyanGFX. I will edit the connected pin numbers. Remove the touch part as it's not needed. This completes all the necessary parts of LovyanGFX. Very simple. As I said, I need to change the touch part. Since it operates in a completely different way from XPT2046, the touch event parts need to be modified as well. The library I use for touch is Dustin's FT6236. I have done multi-touch tests with this for FT6236 in the past project. It worked very well, so let me use it again this time. It's not registered in the Arduino library, so you need to download it yourself and install it in your Arduino library folder. I will write the necessary code, include the FT6236 header file. Because it communicates with I2C, serial data line and serial clock line are connected. Let me define this connected pin number first. Let's create an object called TS from class FT6236. After TFT is initialized, the touch panel will be initialized too. At this time, you can adjust the touch sensitive as the first parameter. The default is 128. If the touch panel cannot be used, a message is output. Go to my touchpad read function that receives touch input from LVGL. Since we are no longer receiving touch values from TFT get touch, we'll fix all of this. The touch point and the point on the screen do not match. The reason is that the display is set to RenderScape mode, but the touch panel is portrait, which is a default. So you have to change this part through code. The y-axis of the touch panel should be the x-axis of the screen, and the x-axis of the touch panel should be the inverse of the y-axis. This may vary depending on the settings on the screen or the default position of the touch panel. This completes the setup of the ST7796 and FT6236. Let's check if the button event is working properly. The touch event is working normally. Each time the button is pressed, the number of the button increases by 1. Whenever you touch the screen, the current touch position is also printing out well. On the screen, the upper left becomes 0,0 and the lower right becomes 480,320. It's working fine. From now on, let's try to run some demos provided by LVGL. Install a library called LVExamples via library. Since LVGL is made to work in many embedded systems such as Arduino as well as STM, some settings are required. After installation, if you look in the LVExamples folder, you will find the LVDemoConfig template header file. Duplicate this file, then rename the file to the LVDemoConfig header file. After that, let's open this file with the text editor. Since we'll be using demo, change this to 1. By default, LV use demo music is set to 1. So first, let's get this to build. I will also change LV demo music autoplay to 1 so that the event is automatically going. If you want to trigger an event by touching it, you can set it to 0. Now let's open the LVGL source LV config header file. Let's modify it to show the current CPU usage and memory usage on the screen. This will show the usage of the CPU in the right bottom of the screen and the usage of the memory in the left bottom of the screen. There is one more thing we need to do to build LVExamples. There is a problem that the images using the demo widget do not refer to the LVGL header file properly. So in order to build without any problems, we need to modify this part. If we define LVGL8 include simple, LVGL header is read normally. In fact, on other platforms, it's possible to do without code modification through additional parameters when building. But since Arduino IDE does not support this kind of function, we have to modify it one by one. If you don't like defining like this, just include LVGL header only. Now back to the source code. Here we add the LV demo header. There is a function called to add a button to the screen at the bottom of the setup. I'll remove this and call LV demo music function. When I build it, it says that the fonts are not defined. If you look at the bottom of the LV config header file, you can choose which font to use. Here, I will use these fonts, Montserrat 12, 16, set to 1. Save and go back to the source code and build it again. This time, it builds without problems. Let's upload and check the result. LVGL's music demo is running normally. Because it's auto mode, it automatically switches the screen. The screen on the left allocates and releases memory using LV memory alloc provided by LVGL, and the screen on the right controls memory through custom malloc and free. You can choose how memory is handled in the LV config header file. You can check the memory usage only by using LV memory alloc. So far, it shows no significant difference. Please test it in your own environment and find the setting values to get the maximum performance in your environment. This time, I will run LV demo widgets. You can find the link to this project in the description below. Open the LV demo config header file. Change LV use demo music to 0 and LV use demo widgets to 1. That's all. Pretty simple, isn't it? I will build it again and upload it to see the results. This demo widget is really well made. It works great like a mobile application. Perhaps you can check all the widgets supported by LVGL through this. Buttons, text input, slider bar, and so on. You can check everything you need for your UI and take what you need and use it. It also supports several types of charts and graphs with animation effects. The demo widget of LVGL 8 is different from the previous version of the LVGL, so it might be a good idea to check it out. As you can see, you can use LVGL to draw great graphics, even on raw power MCUs. I will do my best to create interesting projects with this. Today's project ends here. Thank you for watching. See you in the next project.